If you're just starting out in Scrivener, you may find yourself forgetting some of the technical terms for things and where they are, and then you end up with post-it notes all over the place. For instance, the editor in Scrivener is not the kind person who fixes your manuscript once you've finished writing it. The editor is this bit here, where you do all of your writing and view your documents. Even if you've been using Scrivener for a while, you can never remember how to do those things that you only need to do once or twice ever, like resetting your spelling from US English to UK English for that one agent, or getting the Pilcrow symbol to show up on the page so that you know how many carriage returns you have between the top of the page and the beginning of your text. For instance, here, where I want to line my dedication up perfectly with the copyright page of my paperback novel. And if you are anything like me, you drive yourself crazy because you imagine everyone else automatically remembers these things. But I assure you, I have taught enough people to know that most of them can't, and it is such an energy suck if you try to work that way. So here are some cheat sheets I made for my writing gang to help jog their memories, and I hope they're going to help you too. There's a picture of the screen with arrows pointing out where the main tools are and what the areas of the interface are called and what happens inside of them. Don't worry, I have made one set for Mac users and another for Windows users, so you don't have to wonder what that would look like in your version of Scrivener. Then there's a section on customizing and navigation via the main menu, and another reminding you of the most important keyboard shortcuts if that's the way you like to work. Of course, a lot of these instructions and keyboard shortcuts are different in Windows than they are on a Mac, so be sure to download the correct cheat sheets for the platform you are using. I have also put together a set of sheets that show you how to customize your toolbar and what all the tools do. There are some great tools there, so investigate all of them in case they will be useful to you. But Scrivener is a huge application that is also for technical writers, screenwriters, and academics who use different tools than you are likely to. Not only are there too many tools to fit onto the toolbar, but you don't want to clutter up your toolbar with the ones that you seldom or never use. So if you're on a Mac, you just drag the tools that you want up into your toolbar and click on Done. In the Windows version of Scrivener, you transfer them to your toolbar via the Available Toolbar Actions box. Sorry, my filming software is on my Mac, so I can't show you what this would look like in action. But don't worry, I have added instructions right here on the cheat sheet. Simply choose the tools you like best for the way you like to work. If you find you move your files up and down in the binder a lot, choose the Move File buttons. My personal favorites are the Copy Format and Paste Format tools, because I am constantly moving text from one document to another, and I use different fonts or different colors to remind me what draft a document is in. My favorite tool to add to my toolbar when I'm working with Windows is the Options tool, which takes me directly to the Options dialog box, where you can adjust such things as the appearance of the interface, text formatting, navigation, etc., and choose where to back up your project. So there you go. If you don't want to be like the Post-it lady, keep your cheat sheets close at hand. Print them out and pin them up behind your computer monitor, or better yet, leave them in PDF format on your desktop where you can open them and do a quick search for the thing you want by holding down Command, Control on a PC, and hitting the F key, which will highlight whatever you are looking for. From your PDF, you can also link directly to the official Scrivener User's Manual for the really technical stuff, or you can link to my website for Scrivener tips and tutorials. Oh yes, if you're on my website, don't forget to fill in your name and email, and then click on the button to access your cheat sheets. Don't worry, I would never share your email, and you won't hear from me unless I find or make cool new resources to help you with your Scrivener. If you stumbled upon this video on YouTube, click on the link in the description below. So this has been Karen from ScrivenerTuts.com, hoping to make your writing life easier so that you can get on with the important stuff like actually writing your book.